Hi everyone, welcome back to Gedo. Today we will show you how to replace LCD and touchscreen assembly on the Samsung Galaxy S10 5G mobile phone. To start, we need to have the right tools to proceed with the repair, which you can find in the description. This replacement guide is based on the LCD assembly with frame installed. First, take out the SIM tray and then the back cover removal. To remove the back cover, it needs to heat gently around the back cover edges until the pasted adhesive becomes soft. For this, we are using a heating pad. Place the back cover side on the heating pad and select the mobile phone heating option and leave it till it completes. Alternatively, you can use a heat gun or hair dryer. Once the heating has completed, use a suction cup to create an opening between the frame and back cover. Next, insert a plastic car pry tool or something similar to cut the adhesive around the back cover. Take out the back cover and then undo 5 screws and disconnect the connector to take out the wireless pad, and also disconnect the battery plug. Next, take out the logic board frame by undoing 4 screws. Next, take out the logic board by disconnecting 4 connector plugs. Next, apply the heat and take out the earpiece unit from the body. Next, move to the bottom and undo 4 screws to take out the secondary board cover with the speaker. Next, disconnect and take out the main ribbon flex. Next, disconnect and pull out the headphone jack. Next, undo 3 screws and take out the charging port board from the body. Next, apply the heat and pull out the vibrator motor from the body. Next, take out the battery from the body. First, apply the heat to soften the glue on the battery. For this, we are using a heat gun. Once you feel the heating is enough, use a car pry tool to cut the adhesive under the battery. And once you have some space, use a pry tool to lift the battery. Now, the only remaining part is the broken front screen assembly with the frame and buttons. For the replacement, there are few different screen types in the market. The most common is the original service pack screen, which comes with the frame and buttons. There is another type, it is original but without the frame. But the repair job is a little bit difficult and time consuming. And the price difference is not that big. And also, there are refurbished and used screens with the frame and without. I would recommend you to go with the screen with the frame and button installed. It can be original, refurbished or used. And this type is commonly available to purchase. Next, take the new screen and start placing removed parts. First, place the earpiece on the frame and then place the logic board. And then secure the SIM tray and two connectors. Next, place the battery with adhesive. Next, secure the logic board frame by adding 4 screws. Next, move to the bottom and first place the vibrator motor on the frame. Next, place the charging port board and secure it with 3 screws. Next, place the headphone jack and secure the connector. Next, place the main flex and connect it from both ends. Next, place the secondary board cover by adding 4 screws. Next, before placing the wireless pad, it is good to connect the battery plug and test the screen functionality by powering up the device. Once the testing has passed, next, place the wireless pad by securing 5 screws and the connector. Next, before installing the main back cover, make sure it has enough glue on it. If not, use B7000 glue on your double-sided back cover adhesive. Finally, we are using binding clips to tie the back cover to the body. If not, you can use some rubber bands and leave them for some time. Hope you have enjoyed the screen replacement guide, and let us know if you have any questions. Please like, share and comment on our videos. Hit the subscribe button for more videos.